response. And so a lot of these questions shouldn't be catching you by surprise.
Right.
Okay. And the governor certainly asked us to approve giving you the keys to, I mean, the most significant economic engine in downstate New York. It certainly impacts my communities on Long Island, impacts most of our communities in downstate New York. So these issues are quite important to us. So when we get into the economics of it, the impact on our commuters, the costs of traveling on railroad and the MTA system become very important. So let's get into that for a second, because it seems like it's every year, every other year, certainly every 3 years at most, that we are looking at fare increases, and we're looking at service cuts, and we're looking at impacts to our commuters. The most recent, obviously, being just a few months ago. Where do you see this going? I mean, do you see a system that is stable financially, where you're no longer going to need to go back into the pockets of commuters asking for fare increases? Are we reaching a point where, given your experience and given the last 6 months that you've been on the job, you can assure us that we can go home and tell our constituents and our commuters that use the system that we've reached a point where we have financial stability at the MTA? Because it seems like, again, it just ratchets in one direction and they should just expect it, and that many people before you, frankly, almost saw it as a matter of course and business as usual to increase fares regularly. What do you say?
You have to answer at many different levels. I mean, I've been in the industry my entire life. It is not an industry that operates in the black. It does not operate at a profit. There isn't a public transportation system in the Western Hemisphere. There isn't a public transportation system, save a few in the world, that don't operate at a deficit and are publicly subsidized. So that's the first point. We do have, in some aspects of the financial plan, better levels of certainty than we had in the past, and there's others we have uncertainty. I believe one of the earlier senators made a question about, you know, real estate taxes. They're very mercurial, and when you're running high on a real estate market, you have not only the revenues you need, but an excess of revenues you need. But when it's a low market, you don't have enough revenues. Okay. So there are some aspects of it that are sound and stable, and others that aren't. One of the things we've moved to, the organization has moved to, in the five-year plans we put together, is a fare increase every 2 years. I think when I've worked other places where you haven't had some degree of expectation to tell people you may see a fare increase every so often, and you go for long periods of time, the fare increase is very impactful and very painful for people. I think we would make a strong argument we would still like to have every 2 year fare increases, but what I would also commit to is doing whatever we can to keep those as minimal as possible. And should revenues be in excess of what expectations are, and we say don't need a fare increase this year because of the revenue situation is much better than we thought it would be, that'd be a good place to be in. There isn't much that most people use as a service where costs don't go up. I think the issue is, where do costs go up in relation to other costs that people have? One of the areas we're concerned about is areas that we don't have control on costs, that's pension and healthcare costs, and we need to be able to get greater certainty around that. And we'll try to do that first starting at the collective bargaining table, because we need to, and in some cases we can't have pensions, that's not a collective bargaining issue, we help from the state legislature on that. But it's an ongoing process, and one of the first steps in the process is the transparency issue. I think one of the things that we put you in a bad position on as an elected official, any one of you, is that if there's an allegation of two sets of books, or there's an allegation that you didn't tell us how bad the problem was, and you just spring that on you, that's a position I do not want to be in. That's a position Joe Loder did not want to be in, and Joe Loder wanted to be in. So I'm totally in line with that. And it's going to be, what I will commit to is keeping a focus on those costs that are controllable of us, so that we can keep the level of